The number of active COVID-19 cases in the Philippines is now at an over three-week high of 54,401. That's after the health department reported more than 6,000 infections yesterday, Monday. The country also registered 241 new fatalities, the highest since April 9th. But the DOH says that this can be attributed to the backlog in cases following an error in the government's COVID-19 digital platform, COVID Gaia. Meanwhile, the highly contagious Delta variant is seen in more areas around the country. In just 4 days, authorities have identified 84 new cases of this variant. But health officials insist that the rise in infections does not indicate a new COVID surge just yet.
Ngayon natin pong inaalam, no, what really happened in these specific areas, if there were really breaches or meron pa ho tayong ibang factors na kailangan tignan. Pero ang pinaka-importante, since nakita natin itong mga ganitong klaseng detalye, tayo po ay mas nag-iigting ng ating mga border controls.
The United States is not lifting its travel restrictions on several countries anytime soon amid the threat of the Delta COVID-19 variant. The United States is also currently barring most non-US citizens who, within the last 14 days, have been in the United Kingdom, Ireland, China, India, South Africa, Iran, and Brazil. The White House says that these restrictions may likely remain in the coming months due to the rising spread of the Delta variant in the United States and overseas. Over 375,000 doses of Pfizer's COVID-19 vaccine arrive in the Philippines. More than 272,000 of these are for Metro Manila, while 51,000 are for the Cebu province. Another 51,000 jabs will be sent to Davao this morning. According to the health department, these doses will be allocated to the regions that have not yet received any of Pfizer's vaccines.
Ultra low freezer, pwede na natin bigyan ngayon. So first time nila mag-a-administer ng Pfizer.
Meanwhile, Israel is sending medical experts to the Philippines again, this time to share their best practices regarding vaccine operations. Last June, Israel sent three of its medical experts to the country to help the government with its vaccine rollout initiatives. According to a study from South Korea, a mixture of shots from Pfizer and AstraZeneca can boost antibody levels by up to 6 times. The details in this report.
A new medical study from South Korea says that a shot of the AstraZeneca coronavirus vaccine, followed by a shot of the Pfizer-BioNTech vaccine, can boost some antibody levels by 6 times, compared to using just 2 shots of AstraZeneca instead. The findings from Korea's Disease Control and Prevention Agency follow a similar study in the UK last month. The studies would support the decision by several countries to allow people who've had a single shot of AstraZeneca to use an alternative for their second dose after AstraZeneca was linked to rare blood clots. It includes Canada, Italy, and China, although the World Health Organization has warned against the practice, saying there isn't enough data about the health impact. The South Korea study specifically focused on levels of what are called neutralizing antibodies, which prevent coronavirus from entering cells and replicating.
The World Bank announces a new financing mechanism that will allow developing nations to purchase more COVID-19 vaccines through the World Health Organization's COVAX facility. This mechanism will allow the COVAX to make advance purchases from vaccine manufacturers based on aggregated demand across countries using financing from the World Bank. Under this new deal, up to 430 million additional doses will be available for delivery between late 2021 and mid-2022 for the 92 countries covered by the WHO's COVAX facility. These doses will be in addition to the vaccine donations given by COVAX. The Philippines is a beneficiary of that WHO vaccine sharing facility.